root and the earth, and turn your vision inwards and let the crown of your head open up to the cosmos. Breathe in, breathe out. And then bring both hands softly to your heart. Keep them away from your body. And then sweep the arms out, up and overhead. Twine the fingers and turn your palms to the sky. Push your heels forward, alert the body. Stretch up, breathe in, breathe out. And easy exhale, come on back with your hands. Tuck your knees in, jump up into happy picnic table. I guess it's called happy picnic table. So the palms are down, shake out your moneymaker. Open and close your jaw, strong on the earth. Right leg up to the sky. Lower down, left leg up to the sky. Lower down, shake out the moneymaker. Inhale, lift the head up and drop the tail down and roll whatever you need to right behind your bottom so that you can find yourself with a little bit of support. Tuck your knees in. Tuck your knees in. Drop the shoulders, toes at eye level, stomach is activated, wing bones squeezing towards each other. Thighs right at your gut, right at your belly. Feel the ribs pressing against your thighs. Pleasant face. Remember the corners of the mouth are heaven bound. Stretch the legs out. Open the top of the feet. Look over your toes. Midline. Arms release. Lift your chest. Lift your chest more. Drop your shoulders. Breathe in, breathe out. Three breaths. One, two, three, and touch, and touch, and touch. Up, out, and over. Rock a little bit side to side, so now you're in a forward bend. Good. Rock a little side to side to release the little buttocks. And then easy, walk your hands on back. Today we're gonna do some single leg stretches. You're gonna open up your right leg and fold your left leg in. Take both hands and come and pull your buns right behind you. Let your hands be by your side. You press a little bit up and out of your waist. Point your right foot, push the right heel. Point the right foot, push the right heel. Press down on the earth so that there's maybe a sliver of space between your buttocks and the mother. Point and stretch, good, breathing. Strengthen your shoulders, strengthen your fingers, breathe. Now the toes are to the ground. Let the arms go to a T. Inhale, arms up and overhead. And then easy, separate the arms, lift up and out of the waist. Spin to the right side, to the right leg, and fold over the top of that thigh. Let the elbows drop on either side of your calf and see if you can spin your torso so that the heart is right over the thigh. Robert, you want to drop your head slightly so the crown is reaching out over your toes. Breathe in, breathe out. Ernesto, come and fix this camera because you're on, but you're filming the umbrella. So turn it this way. I can see it. Yeah, that's pretty good. You can take this umbrella problem. Breathing. Now easy, walk the hands back towards your knee, straighten your elbows. Take your left hand, stretch it out parallel to the leg, and go to the outside of the upper calf. The left hand is going to go to the front of the outside of your upper calf. The right arm is going to stretch up to your shoulder level and open out. So you're twisting the body. You're using that leg as a lever and you can fold the right hand onto your waist. Stretch your neck, open your eyes, look up to the sky. That's good, that's good, that's good. Breathing. And then release that right arm. Keep it at shoulder level so you don't wreck your shoulder. Come back around to your leg. Four fingers on one side, right thumb on the inside of your calf. Left arm's gonna stretch forward beyond the toes. Let your eyes follow the left arm up to the sky and open up your wings. Keep it up in the air first, Robert. Keep it up so you're nice and wide. Alert that leg, Joel. Make sure that, so the toes are towards your nose. Lift your chest, drop the shoulder from the ears. How are you all doing? You look great. Breathing. Of course, there's a bunch of blank spaces too. There you are, breathing. And now lower that arm gently, that left arm, around your lower back. Around your lower back. And press on your lower back so you can roll the top shoulder, extend the neck, look up to the sky. Don't forget the right toes are still pointing towards your right ear. That leg is engaged, creating a design, a geometric design on the ground. Lifting the chest, spinning the ribs. And now easy, release that left arm, let it float up and overhead, and take your lower arm and drop the elbow inside the thigh so you can push and stretch and drop that top arm over your ear, pointing towards your toes. Lift your chin, sink in there if you're able. Open the side ribs, exaggerate your breath, please. Let me see you breathe large and big. What happened, baby? There you go, lift your chin, Karen. That's a girl breathing. And then you know how we go. Breathe into that left rib cage. Inhale, lift the arm up and the body up. Angle so that you're in a nice open bird position. And then scoop that, oh beautiful. Scoop that right arm up and leap up onto that shin bone. Open and close your jaw. Stretch the body, angle, reach, press on your foot as well. Straight leg, right leg straight. And then lower on down, and remember Mr. Sibley, ta-da. If I can't get on Zoom, neither can you, that's for sure. Arm up and over your head, slide on down, humbly nestling your thumbs at your breastplate. Settle in and scan the body. The twisting, that bringing ourselves into a place of participating in our well-being, destagnating the body, uncrystallizing, breaking up the clog of energy and chaos, breaking it up so that we're clear and sweet and easy. Remember to be grateful. Find ourselves grateful, grateful for the sweet air, grateful for the smell of spring, grateful to be united in this techno challenge. And slide on down, bring your right leg in, happy cactus. You know how to do this, the birds are laughing. You're gonna easy, take both hands, dive off to the left, hands down, buns up, spin around, flop down. Don't think, don't think, don't think, don't think. Just go, go, go. If you think, it makes a big mess about things. So good, easy. Guess what happens? Out goes the left leg. Pull your little buns back so that you can actually anchor your sit bones, those two little butt bones, into the earth. They say that's not true, but give yourself some space from the ribs. Lift and pull away from the crest of your hip bones. Let's add some breaths. Easy. Inhale, lift up and down. Lift up. Large birds. One more. Hold it up. A little more. Separate the arms. Sit here, push that left heel, point the left toe, push the left heel, point the left toe. I can only see your glasses, Michelle. I love it. Push the heel, point the toe, push the heel. Inhale, lift up and out of your waist and spin towards the straight leg and dive on down. Ah, bow down, single leg, forward bend. Twist and torque the body, angle yourself, get organized with how the vehicle moves. How does that body change? How is it able? So you go where you're able. If both hands are on your left thigh, that's fine. Both hands carrying on the left thigh, that's good. Or both hands on the calf. Or you can grab the foot and drop on down. And then easy, slide your hands on back with the spider fingers so you're near your knee. Lift your chest, drop the shoulders, push that left leg. Be alert in that left leg. And easy, you're going to raise that right arm and go to the outside of your shin bone. You're going to use that like a lever, like you're trying to pry a door open. Then your left arm stretches forward over your toes and it lifts up. And then it winds around. You can go a little higher than shoulder level. Wind around and grab your lower back. Lift the chest so you spiral. You accentuate this ability of your body to mobilize. Rotate that left shoulder back and away from your ear. Push the left heel. Lift the chest. Pleasant face. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Another breath. That's nice. And then easy. Release that arm carefully with your shoulder. Come around all the way down to the shin bone. Left hand. Four fingers on the outside, thumb on the inside. Release the right arm. Stretch forward on your toes. Sweep through the sky, looking up, pointing at the heavens, and arc that body open so that the shoulders are stacked up in the same line as the legs. The arms are open like big wings. Lift the chest, breathe in, breathe out. Open the chest. Oh, beautiful. Exaggerate the breath. Lift. And then softly let that right arm just mosey on down to your lower back. Let it fold in on the lower back. Use the inside of your calf to open the heart towards the heavens. Really round that thoracic spine up towards the sky. Lengthen the neck, open the eyes, lift the chin, breathe in, breathe out, create space. Massaging those organs, increasing the wellness being of self. Breathe in, breathe out. And then softly release that back arm, that top arm. Let the right arm come up to the sky and take your left elbow inside your thigh and stretch that right arm up or over your ear. Easy. Drop down, let that elbow, that left elbow get heavy towards the ground. That's good. Breathing, stretching, you can feel that skin. That's why we have a little bit of fat there, you know? So we can stretch like this, pulling that angled body, that oblique connector away. Open and breathe. Ah, and here we go. Inhale. Into that right rib cage. Spiral the arms, lift up, open, and sweep through the inside chakra lineup. Open up. Press on the left foot. Open the chest. Reach, reach, reach. And then easy. Down we come, and we add the old ta-da, ta-da. Hi, Ernesto. Ta-da! Ta-da. Arms overhead, slide on down. Softly gathering into the chest. We continually find ourselves in grace and gratitude. finding something to be grateful for. Grateful for the help, grateful for the ease. Bring that left leg in. Happy cactus, jazz hands. La, 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 la. La, 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 la. Dance for your electricity. And then easy, we dive to the right. Hands down, buns up. Spin around and plop down. Good, easy. I'm gonna turn a little bit to the side, but you're gonna open up your legs. Open up the legs, rock a little bit side to side. How are you doing, Kevin? Oh, there you are. Hi, Kevin. Yes. No shade. Easy, side to side. Open the legs out, hands back by the bottom. Push the heels. Try and touch your elbows. Ah, beautiful. Lift the chest up. Lift your chin up a little bit. Point the toes. Push the heels. Point the toes. Check out the dust on your ceiling fan. Push the heels. I'm happy to see the sky. Point the toes. Thank you for joining me in the garden. Try and make it pretty for you. We're not very good at the other part, but point the toes. Push the heels. Lift the chest. Point the toes. Push the heels. And easy. Release the arms to a T and just spin a little bit with wings. Just spin. Keep your legs straight. I got a bunch of fat doves around here. Spin, spin, spin. Lift the arms overhead and then drop down to your shin bones. Breathe. Let your eyes be soft and easy. You begin to activate that interior vision, that place that imagines the lungs expanding and moving those ribs underneath your arms. Imagine that brow is unfurled. We're at Taco Moon, you know, so that intuition, we need to listen to our intuition. We want to be clear and smooth to the forehead. The Cyclops, that six chakra, intuits, we grok, where we connect with all of our intuition to know our truths. Easy, lift your chest up and exhale. Just drop your right shoulder down and look to the left. Lift up and drop your left shoulder down and look to the right. Lift up, just pulsing down towards the earth. Let your elbows bend and pressure on your shins so it gives you a little bit more angle, a little bit more action towards. Talk to the legs. How are you doing, Robert? Are you moving? Okay, pulsing down towards the ground. Open up the rebar. Go a little deeper, Joel. Once more each side. And easy, back into the center. Bring your hands back behind you. Try and touch your elbows. You're gonna lift your buns up and point your toes. Lift the buns up, point the toes. Squeeze the elbows together, lift the chest. Put some action in your ass, in your rump. Breathe. And then down you go and easy. Hands are going to jump out in front of you. You're going to lift the chest. Toes are to the sky. Lift the chest. Pulse down to the earth. Lift the chest. Pulse down to the center. Lift the chest. Let your head drop down. Good. Try and keep the palms off. Just use your spider fingers. That's it. And come back up and exhale. Inhale up, exhale, inhale up, exhale, inhale up, seated squat, exhale down. Three more, one, and down, and two, and down, and three, and down. Inhale, lift up, jump your hands back behind you, roll your hips in, lift the leg up and bring it into a forward bend. So you pull the bottoms. Lift your arms overhead, Exhale and try and grab your toes, drop your elbows, kiss your knees. See if you're not beginning to loosen up a little bit. Oh, so many of you all disappear. I can't see you. What happened? There you are. Hey, socks, what's your favorite position? The forward bend. Toes are like in Europe. The bottom is in New York. Breathe. Good. Breathe easy. Then walk your hands back. Bring your knees in. Stretch the feet. Open the feet wide to the outside of your mat. Let your hands be behind you. Feet are nice and wide. And just pulse the knees side to side. Keep the feet wide. Let the knees really touch. Continuing to equalize the stretch. One side of your body will be more available and more limber and easier to mobilize or connected to your brain. So softly, let the knees go side to side. Good. Let the knees touch all the way down, Chris. That's good. It's a bit of a sassy move. You know, if you kind of extend the chest away from your pubic bone, when the knees touch, you get a lot of opening opposite from driving the car, sitting at the computer, chowing down at the sous la table. Once more, each side. Stay on your right side. Pulse that left hip up. Pulse the left hip up. And then easy, pulse that hip and spiral the body. You're going to reach with your left arm over around your back. You're going to turn that lower hand so the fingers are away, pointing away from your body. You're going to stretch and breathe and stretch out that left leg nice and long. Breathe in and breathe out. Hello. Breathe in and breathe out. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Left arm up. Easy, slide back in. Feet nice and wide. And easy, down to the left side. Pulse that right hip up. Just creating space and agility, mobility in your body, flexibility. It's interesting how all those words have ability, the ability to connect to your vessel, to connect to your temple, to create space and strength. And then easy, pulse that right hip up, spiral and add the drama, turn the lower hand, look all the way over the left shoulder, over the right fingertip. And then reach that right leg far away from your body. Open up the psoas. That's beautiful. Stay on the ground, twisting, breathing, torquing. You add that torque to the body, that squeezing of the wash rag. Inhale, lift that right arm up. And roll back onto your back. Rock side to side. Pull the bottom back. And let's just see how the forward bend is working. Thank you. Arms up and overhead. Toes to the nose. Exhale, bow down. See if you're... Wow! Are you much further in your forward bend? Shake your head. Yeah, yeah, mama, yeah. And then easy, walk your hands on back. So I think we should tuck the feet in and go into child's pose, go into a little downward dog to continue the circulation and plumping up of the body, and then we'll go down and fix the hips. So let's roll over into child's pose, and while you're there, remind yourself that it's such a blessing to be able to be on this earth like this, to open your knees nice and wide, to walk yourself down in between your thighs, to relax yourself down to the ground, snuggle on down, get your head below your heart, and bow down to, it's Sunday. In any day we bow down to, we bow down in gratitude for this opportunity to yoke or join our body, mind, and spirit. We bow down with the awareness and the consciousness and the direct energy of plumping up our relationship with our guides and our gods, of plumping up and strengthening our physical form. So the kundalini, the chi, the life force, the cerebral spinal fluid nestled at the base of your spine is just rolling softly up your spine into the center of your brain. Your head is below your heart. This relaxation pose takes the anxiety and the tension out of this experience we're in. We want to be able to maintain a relationship with our center. Don't let the Rona take the advantage or the chaos person. Allow yourself to find your center, to release the valves in your heart, to feed the pineal gland, to feed the pituitary, to soften in your protection of your inner thighs, to allow your belly, your emotional center, to release, to circulate. Absolve yourself of the responsibility for the chaos. Invite yourself to be intuitive, to be self-care, be gentle with yourself. Breathe in, breathe out, relax, restore. So easy, and to come up onto all fours. And easy, pull your knees into parallel. Look at your hands, those beautiful, strong hands. Look at those hands and get yourself organized. Shake your tail, articulate the spine, the old cat and the cow. Let your hips become fluid and easy. You can wag your tail like a big sachet, like a big boa. Wag the tail and articulate, exhale and inhale. Move the spine, stretch, press the earth away, get connected. And then easy, come in and curl your toes under, roll your shoulders back, look at your palms, activate the inner elbows, shoulders are down. Inhale, lift up your right arm and your left leg. Right arm and your left leg. Go ahead and hold it up there. Good stretch. She needs a headband today. Stretching, and the other two are below. Somebody's in the flowers. Oh, gosh, you're so cute. Good. And then if you're thrill seeking, go ahead and bend that back leg in, grab the ankle, lift the chest. Yeah, get that thigh a little higher. See how long it's been since you've had yoga, Mr. Herrera? Lift the thigh high. Don't brag. Breathe. Press that fingertip. Release the arm. Lower down. Open and close. Wag the tail. Oh, I feel those chips. I've been eating chips. I feel the chips in my waist. Now get your head back on your shoulders. Isn't that what your grandma used to always tell you? Get your head back on your shoulders. Spread the fingers, easy, curl the toes. Inhale, lift up the left arm and the right leg. Reach through the back foot, reach through the back toes, reach through the front fingers. Parallel to the ground, how are you all doing? Breathe, straight arm, straight leg, whoa, whoa, whoa. Suck it up a little bit, use your forefinger, use your thumb. Good job. Inhale and exhale, grab that back ankle, lift it up. Oh, one side's always better than the other, yes? Keep smiling, thigh high. Come on, have this. And easy, release. And lower down. And open and close, open and close. Curl the toes, sit back on your heels, walk your hands out in front of you. Spread your fingers wide. Inhale, lift up your knees to your chest into a little squat. Drop your head, shake. Lift up onto all 10 toes and pedal your knees. Breathe. Inhale, back into plank or into plank for the first time. 7 breaths. Squeeze your buns. Get your belly. Line your head up with your spine. Spread your fingers. Breathe. Yeah, it would be good to do some push-ups. And then drop your knees, and here you go. Hey, careful. The head weighs 10 to 15 pounds. Keep it connected, Chris. Elbows are in. Bosoms to the thumbs. Oh, grunt and sit back on your heels. Baby girl push-ups. Inhale. Oh, they're so hard. Elbows stay getting raw right against your ribs. Oh, okay. We're going to 5 at least. This is 4. Oh, come on. Those dingle dangles are showing in the summer bathing suits. 5. 2 more. Come on, come on, come on. You can do it. You can try. Oh, once more. Oh, mother. Here you go. It was already Mother's Day. Come down onto your stomach. And easy to slide your elbows forward. Lift up into proud space and shake your hips. Breathe. Then find yourself in space. Bless you. Long legs. Little toes on the ground. Heart forward. Shoulders back. Press down on your forearms. Look over your shoulder, see if you can see your heel. Look over your shoulder, see if you can see your other. Bless you. Back into the center. Stretch your belly, kids. Stretch your belly. Shoulders are down. Heart comes forward. Reach. And easy. Lower on down. Hands underneath the shoulders. Up onto all fours. Wag your tail. Cha-cha-cha. Cross your ankles, sit back on your ankles, and roll around onto your backs. Tuck your knees into your chest. Ernesto, you might have to come out here and check the camera. Please.
So I can see this camera. I can see both cameras.
Okay. Well, you know, I'm down now. Easy. Hold on to your knees. Am I on the thing? Roll the knees around. Good. Oh, relax that lower back. You can see my flowers. You can see the Buddha and the elephant. Reverse the spin. Breathe in, breathe out. And tuck those knees into the chest. I can't hear you.
See Robert's feet.
Okay. So easy. Drop your feet down onto the mat beside you. Let your arms release, and you're either going to make little fists, or you're going to lift your bottom and cross your arms underneath. And depending on your familiarity with inversions, depending on your blood pressure medication, any issues with your neck, and Corey is in labor right now, by the way. Our sweet Corey, Sebastian, the baby boys, they're on the way to the hospital. So easy, tuck your knees into the chest and let's stretch the legs up to the sky. Push the feet and easy, just in a nice L position. Just allow the soles of your feet to be to the heavens. Remember this release of the arterial valves, the release of the valves in the body. The feeding of your gut. Make sure the legs are straight. Breathing in, breathing out. Feel yourself connected. Look at your feet. You can see how your ankles go. Feel the back of your skull. Breathing easy. And then if you wish, you can bend the knees, drop the feet onto the floor, and kick up into a low, modified shoulder stand. Just kick up and grab your buns. Keep your outer upper thighs squeezed together, like you kind of activate the bottom. You look at your toes, and the inner meridian, that midline of your legs, is organized. The pressure's on the back of your skull and on your upper arms. You want to breathe and easy. Good. You want to make sure you want to. You're going to, you want to, you're going to, you want to. You're going to, you want to. Just imagine that interior, that release, that those swollen ankles and that pulling. Gravity pulls fluids in your body towards the ankles and the earth. So allow yourself to receive kind of that cosmic food, that energy from the sky. Let yourself relax down. And then easy, bend your knees in, roll down softly, and drop your bottom and just open your hands into a happy baby. So you grab the outside of your feet. Grab the outside baby toe line of your feet. Get your knees into your armpits and rock a little bit side to side to massage that lower back. Feel yourself easy. Your head go with you. Let yourself just massage into the earth. Now bring your hands inside your calves and open your legs out into a big Y or a V, as it were. Wow, crackle, crackle. And then roll your feet around on your ankles, full range of motion. Remember, you're tracing the face of an analog clock with your big toe. It gives you a lot more rotation in the ankle than you are used to, I would presume. Roll the other direction. Let the weight of your hands on the inside of your calves or your thighs spread your legs a little more. Again, rock a little bit side to side. Breathe in, breathe out. And then easy, take your hands outside your thighs, squeeze the legs together, and this time anchor your ankles and your big toe and point the toes to the sky. Flatten your belly, arms overhead, arms behind your head, elbows open, hands cupping your skull. Breathe in, breathe out. Now flex the feet to the sky. Elbows are open. And now point the toes to the sky. Change the hand that's cupping your skull. Open up your elbows. Try and touch the ground. Exaggerate your breath. Stretch across your bosoms, across your chest. Feel those lower ribs active. And push the heels now. Flex. Three breaths. One, two, three. Inhale, lift your head up, look at your toes, tuck your knees into your chest, relax your feet down onto the ground. Hare Krishna, left foot over the right thigh. Do reverse pigeon just to loosen up your hips for the mid of May. And just take both hands and slip around your right thigh, tuck it into your chest. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, hail to the divine within. Sweetness of the breeze, stretch that right leg up. Stretch. Breathing, fold it in. Unhook your legs, drop your feet onto the ground, bend the knees. Bounce your pelvis. Boom, 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 boom. Breathe. Tuck the knees into the chest, always realigning that sacrum and that lower back. Drop both feet on the ground. Take your right foot over your left thigh. Lift your head and grab both sides of the left thigh and tuck it into your chest. Breathing in and breathing out. Ah, it's so beautiful. Stretch that left leg to the sky. Really breathe into the areas of resistance in the body. Try and relax your neck. Straighten that leg there, Kevin. More. More. Breathe easy. And then easy, go ahead and roll back on. And roll that foot down. Drop both feet onto the ground. Bounce your hips. Boom, 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 boom. And then give yourself a hug. Since you can't give anybody else hugs right now, give yourself a hug. Arms out in a T. Knees glued together. Toes to the sky. Inhale. Exhale, both knees to your right side. Look left. Keep the knees above the waist. Breathe in, breathe out. Allow the muscles and the tendons and any of that angst and ache to soften. Inhale, exhale, back onto your back. Keep the knees tucked up to your waist. Roll off to the left side. Keep the knees above the waist. Please breathe. Please settle in and relax. Enjoy the relationship with the earth. Feel the support. Feel the ease. And then easy back into the center. Rock a little bit side to side. Stretch your legs out long. Arms are by your side. You're going to take a big breath in and lift your feet, your legs, your arms and shoulders and head off the ground 3 inches and squeeze. Inhale, lift, squeeze, hold it, squeeze. And then, relax. Totally flop down onto the ground. Take a nice deep exhale. Sigh. Relax, release, restore, renew. Give yourself every opportunity. Recharge your body, you know. Relax. Call into your gods. Call into your guides. Let your large muscles drop away from your bones. Let your body become hollow, soul, feet. Relax those inner muscles in that connected area in your pelvis. Large muscles drop away. Feel your body nestled, settled into the arms of the mother. The embrace of the earth. Your lips are plump, your face is smooth, your eyes dive deep into that interior landscape. Self-connect with the void. Your breath be natural and easy. Remind yourself that you play in this area of the inhale and the exhale, this area of the sun and the moon, the right side and the left side, the inside and the outside, the sun, the moon, the songs of the birds, over coagulation. Feel yourself releasing into the nectar, that honey-like amaret surrounds your body so that your ether body is smooth, sweet, sweet like the honey of the honeybees. Your ribs soften, let your dreams roll around. Try not to get distracted by anything. hollow, natural, happy, healthy, holy, magnificent, valiant, divine. Radiate goodness, radiate grace. Release those crevices and those areas of compression. So with this time, service is of the essence. Service will make you feel better. Simplicity of calling those that are alone, all the funny party friends of yours that are holed up on the couch. Just check in with the strange parts of your family that you haven't really connected with in a long time. Reestablish that tribal connection, that orbital flow. Remember some of your friends in foreign countries that you haven't seen for years. The old adage, of course, you need your blood. Give kindness and happiness and grace. Yeah. Breathe in and breathe out. Sweet like the honey of the honeybees. Hollow and clear channel between the heavens and the earth. When we remember to consciously relax, when we remember to allow ourselves to be a channel between the heavens and the earth, we remember the magic, the alchemy, that combination of stuff that brings us peace and awareness, global intention. Breathe softly into your navel point, that original source, umbilicus. Breathe into the belly. Breathe in and exhale, and breathe in and exhale. Then breathe into your fingers. Breathe into your toes. Let your fingers wiggle and your toes wiggle. Let your thumbs slide across your fingertips. Calmly reconnecting that nervous system, feeling that ether body that surrounds you, your energy field is smooth, wonderful. And then easy inhale and exhale, bring the hands to your heart. Gather in all that sweetness, all that love, all that light, all that joy and all that abundance, all that strength, all that willingness, and all that grace. Find your fingers and roll your arms up and overhead, pressing the palms away from you. Step your straight legs together and point your toes and push your heels. Wiggle through your shoulders. Open and close your mouth. Flutter your eyelashes. Inhale and exhale. Tuck your knees into your chest. Give yourself a hug. And easy. You can roll to your right side. We're in that funny area now, that wheelchair right side, gathering your strength, your resiliency, your willingness to look at things from a different perspective, press up to a seated position that's comfortable for you. Eyes are soft, spine is straight, jaw is relaxed. Your seatedness, your rootedness. Extended spine, the trembling and tingling at the crown of your head as you yearn for conscious contact, for a relationship with the divine, a conscious relationship. Easy, let's sweep the arms out, up and overhead. Breathe in. Press the palms and fingers together, lifting up. Hold the baby finger and thumb. Spread the fingers and humbly slide down your heart line, receiving all that beautiful energy. Nestle your thumbs in your best place. And exhale, the fingertips come together. And giftedness, we find ourselves in this ancient salutary greeting, where we bow and we greet and we honor and we welcome the life within ourselves and others, and we know the sameness of our breath and the sameness of our blood. Thank yourselves for being part of this urban yoga caretaking adventure. I thank you deeply for being part of this. You're willing to show up for your patience, for your enthusiasm, for your tips in the tip jar, for Ernesto the wizard, and we send a ton of blessings to Corey and her baby coming. So it's quite a generation. Namaste. Namaste. Call me if you need me. Love you. Thank you so
much. Namaste.
Namaste, darling.
Bow down.
Thank you for coming, Easy. Thank you so much.
Namaste.
Easy. Thank you, everybody.
Everybody's welcome. Good. Kristen, namaste.
Namaste. Thank you, Robert.
Thank you, Kristen.
Hi, Dane. Hi, Kev. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Oh, hey, Marie. Hi. Hi, guys. Hi, Michelle. Thank you so much. Love you all. Yay. Oh,
thank you.
William.
See you Tuesday, Kristen.
Thank you for your letters. I love getting letters. They're so sweet. Thank you. Oh, I didn't tell you the good news about the bigger space. Okay, stay tuned. See you on Tuesday. See you on Tuesday.
All right.
All right. See you, beautiful garden. See the beautiful birds. All right. See you on Tuesday.